Zoran Theodorovich, aka the Mighty Z. We got Gabe from Enterprise Earth on the phone. Happy 4th of July. How are you doing, my friend?
Yeah, happy 4th, man. Doing well. How are you?
I'm doing great. Are you ready to cook some hot dogs and burgers and hang out with the family?
I guess so. I'm out here in New Mexico. I don't have any hot dogs, but I do have some really good chorizo. So doing a little more New Mexican style out here.
How long have you been in New Mexico?
I've been here on and off for like the past 4 years or so. I currently live in a place called Taos. It's like a little mountain town in northern New Mexico.
Oh yeah, I played a show once in Dixon, which is
right down the street.
I don't know. Yep. Mm-hmm. The place called the Dingo Bar. I'm sure it's not there anymore. It was a long time ago. But
I'm not sure. I haven't been down to Dixon too often. Yeah, that's about like 45 minutes southish, I think, of here. Something like that.
Oh, okay. Right on.
Yeah.
And now, first of all, the new EP kicks butt. You must be stoked.
Yeah, man. It was a lot of fun to record and produce, and it looks like the reaction from it has been great so far. So yeah, we're all very stoked on it.
And it's the second EP you guys have put out, right?
Yeah. The very first release that Enterprise put out was the 23 EP back in 2014. In between that and this EP were three full lengths.
And did the EPs close out the album before it, or are they taste of things to come?
So this one I would call it more of just kind of like bridging the gap between our last record, Luciferous, and what will be coming on our next LP, which is currently in the works.
And it was released on Juneteenth with a NAACP Legal Defense Fund tie-in. You want to talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, so we decided to put it on June 19th, and of course, you know, realized the significance of that holiday, and of course, everything that's, you know, crazy going on in the world right now. We thought it would be the least we could do just to donate some of the proceeds to the NAACP Legal Defense Fund. And our label, E1, was also donating 100% of Bandcamp sales from the EP on Juneteenth as well to the same fund.
Do you want to share a little bit about your views on BLM and how they may be similar or different than that of someone like Candace Owens or a follower of QAnon?
The whole movement right now, it's great that it's bringing like more awareness just to the whole situation. And, I hope people can start being more kind to one another, like moving forward from all this, because there really is no place for hate or bigotry or racism in this world. So hopefully everyone can learn. From all this craziness.
I would say that your particular brand of metal is your fan base is metal in general is pretty white, but I noticed in your particular genre there seems to be a little more a little more ethnic diversity. Would you agree with that?
I guess our bassist Robbie is black. And there's, you know, you have guys like, you know, as far as other black metal musicians like Adam Warren from Oceano, Kyle from Brand of Sacrifice, you know, there's, you know, but I guess metal is, I guess, maybe primarily white, but I don't know. I don't really see it in those terms of black or white or anything like that. So.
And you cover pretty much my all-time favorite Lamb of God song. What was your first experience with Lamb of God?
It was listening to Ashes of the Lake, that whole album. That was Lamb of God was one of the first bands that got me in at the metal. I think the first Lamb of God song I ever heard was like Ruin or something like that. But then I was like hooked after that, and then Ashes of the Lake is one of my favorite metal records. That's also one of Dan's our vocalist. So when the idea came up of like covering a log song, we're like, we were all very stoked and excited to do it.
And you also cover Necrophagist as well. Do they fall in line under one of your biggest influences?
Oh, yeah. I mean, for me personally, Necrophagist is a huge one for me in terms of riffs and solos. The guitarist, Muhammad, has always been, like, a big inspiration on me. And, yeah, as well as on our drummer, Brandon. So that was that. Necrophagist was actually our drummer, Brandon's idea. He was like, we should do a Necrophagist song. And I was like, okay. I'm definitely up for the challenge. Yeah, that one was also a lot of fun to do.
You were on tour when the corona hit the fan. Talk a little bit about how it all fell apart as we are all living during an historic event.
Yeah, we were in Berlin, and then towards the end of a European tour, we had three shows left. We were, on the bus in Berlin after our show, and got the news of the travel ban, and then, we had to book emergency flights home the next day, and our North American tour with Virus Murder got canceled. All in all, we lost, I don't know how many, tens of thousands of dollars of revenue. But it is what it is. It's a bummer, but out of our control, so they just take it one day at a time and just do what you can to keep moving forward.
Have the fans stepped up to help offset any of the costs, the losses that you've incurred?
Yeah, we had whenever we got settled back home, we had a big sale on our website with all the tour merch, and we're so grateful for our fans. They're incredible, and they really helped us a lot there when we had that big drive. And since we've been home, we feel very grateful to have such a supportive fan base that can help us out. And we can't wait to get back out there to play for them again.
There is no tomorrow. Is a refreshing break from the devastation that Enterprise is known for. Enterprise Earth is known for. I'm sorry.
That one was the acoustic version of There's No Tomorrow. That was like a last minute addition that we just kind of threw on. And we were very excited to do that because our musical influences and range goes much more and deeper than just being brutal. And we really wanted to showcase that, and we were all really, really, really stoked on how the acoustic version of that song turned out.
Have the fans warmed to that? I know sometimes fans can be pretty close-minded to change.
Sure. And actually, the fan response has been great. It's been awesome. I really haven't seen much, if any, negative feedback at all for that song. It's the first time that they've really heard Dan sing, and we were hoping to surprise people in the best way possible with that one.
There is no social distancing at a metal gig, at an Enterprise Earth gig. Are you ready to play drive-ins?
I don't know. I mean, like, it's cool seeing, like, the drive-in stuff. It's cool seeing, like, the Twitch streaming stuff. It's awesome. I mean, there's not that active, which I think that's very important. But it's just, especially for a metal show, I don't know, it just doesn't feel the same, like when you're not, close by, like a bunch of other people, like the energy just isn't there. The energy isn't as great, as powerful as if, you had a few hundred, a few thousand people in a room close together. So who knows? We'll see what happens.
What other cover songs are part of the Enterprise Earth arsenal, if needed?
It's just those two covers at the moment, just Lamb of God and Necrophagist. We may be working on some other things in the future. Covers are certainly, it's something that we can do during this downtime as well, aside from, creating original music. Covers are fun. They're a little easier to produce because the song's already written. You just got to do your version of it. We'll see. We may do another one or two here or there.
And what have you been binging or playing during the lockdown besides work?
I'm fortunate enough to have a job here in South. So I've just been working. Was working on the EP and just doing music stuff. So honestly, my daily life hasn't changed too much at all. Fortunately. Same old, just work here in New Mexico and working on music.
Well, cool. Thank you, Gabe. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk to me. And we look forward to seeing you again when you come back, when it's all over. Do you have any final thoughts you might like to share with somebody that might be listening to this?
Sure. If you're listening, feel free to check out our website, enterpriseearthband.com. We have a bunch of new Foundation of Bones related merch and other things up there, CDs and vinyl for our last album, Lucifer First, are up there as well. And we're going to be today we just put out a playthrough for the Necrophages cover, and we'll be putting out videos every Friday in July. So be sure to keep checking back on our channel soon for more content.